Session started, so welcome everyone after lunch. This is another session on quantum cognition. And the first paper is titled "Is Stress Quantified?" Leonardo and Petro have been jointly presenting this paper, so I'll leave the floor to you to start, Leonardo.
Thank you very much. I split my presentation in two parts, first around motivation. So it's very well known from this community that the question order can be represented by quantum formalism. And in this talk, I'd like to address the interesting topic that is try to investigate the same question in physiological data. So, as Cassio told before, if you make two questions in different organs to two different populations, we can receive a different answer depending on the order of the question. Of course, this is an example of non-commutativity. The problem is that the standard probability does not respect this property. So for standard probability, there is no anti-commutativity. And we want you to make the same question now for stress situation. Stress situation is a moment when we have a conflicting conditions. So a person under stress is a person that needs to make a decision in a very fast way, and when the ability to arrive at a decision is very hard. So this motivates the theme, the title of this presentation. Is stress quantum-like? The answer to this question, we investigate two experiments. That's one of the reasons why we call this work to this conference. We were very interested in to make this answer this question under physiological data, and it was very, very hard to find in literature works that report the data in such a way that we can use to answer this question. So even our results here are not so conclusive. We'd like to address this theme, the theme under the idea to invite you to invest in this kind of research. Of course, quantum formalism leads to order effect. For example, imagine that I make two questions to a physical system, a proposition A and a proposition B. So I can ask if a particle in a direction z has a spin plus half. Of course, we can receive as an answer yes or no. There is this print here as plus. Okay. So for PB, I can make a different question. For example, I am in a different direction of z, I can also have a spin plus half. So this is a very well known result from basic quantum mechanics. But the same works when I make a questionnaire, as a Cassio in the last seminar show. If I make the question, is Bill Clinton honest and trustworthy? And if I make the question, is Al Gore honest and trustworthy? I'll get different results depending on the order that I make the questions. Of course, this is a situation that is equivalent in quantum mechanics to a non-compatible. In the quantum formalism, I can formulate the two I can answer the two questions by making a measurement. So, for the first question, I can formulate the question as operator PI. And for the complementary question, one means operator PI, four means operator PI, both for I, A and B. And again, according to standard quantum mechanics, I can get the answers using these expressions. But then for the answer for our question is simply P, A, B. I'm talking about the order. So if I make the question A followed by the question B, I have this sandwich that is PC, PA, PB, PA, PC. In a similar way, if I make the question in the different order, I have the following possibilities. I'm going a little bit fast because I'm just making a revision. Okay, so with these probabilities, I can construct two methods. One for questions made in order AB and other in questions made in order BA. Of course, if the order doesn't matter, the subtraction of one matrix by other will be equal to zero. Because it doesn't matter, don't make a difference. But if the result of the components of the subtractions is different of zero, we have an example of odd effect, but not of quantum odd effect. To establish a quantum odd effect, I need to make the sum of diagonal of the matrix subtraction here, and you get this Q. And if this Q is equal to zero, we have a quantum order effect. So we try to find in literature situations where we can test this possibility. The best work that we found for beginning was by Burns and Loris. These are both behavioral experiment and neurological experiment. But the brain data they have, they didn't display in a way that we can use. So we focus in a behavioral data. So in this experiment, they use noise as a sort of stress. And they put the subjects to a game. They present I'll jump here to show the situation to explain better. They show to the participants a black screen with a cross in the middle. So after that, they show two rectangles, and they ask the participants to establish a strategy to figure out will be the square to be selected. And for each right answer, they receive an amount of money, euros, 5 or 25. Or they lose that amount of money. So the subject was in a situation to try to establish a strategy. So the sequence of the experiment was like that. First the black string with a cross, after two squares. After the subject make a choice, the one of the square was illuminated with a specific color that would vary from a group of experiment to another, that show if they win or lost that game. And this is a stressful situation because they make an illumination of the square, but they didn't say how much they won or lost. After some time, depends on the amount that the person wants. So, repeating this process many times, the subject was invited to establish a strategy. The point was, all outputs of the system had equal probability, and they didn't know. So there is no way to establish a strategy that will make them win. So now I'm showing a table that show depend of the order, and they put the science of noise. How much time the subject stay using the same strategy? So in the first table you see a situation on first the subject make the experiment on silence without any noise, and the second half with noise, and the second table reverse the order: first noise and after silence. So since this results are given in a percentage, you can make a translation to probability in a straightforward way. So, in a situation with silence followed by noise, we have that we have an average the same value, 0.665. And when they put noise first, you see that in the first situation we have a number that was smaller than the sequence. Of course, with this data, we didn't have enough information to make a joint distribution to calculate the degree equality. So, what we knew that was not a strong supposition was to assume that it was an independent situation, that you can make a joint distribution assume independence. Under this assumption, we got these results for the two matches. And after we make the subtraction of those matches, we obtain the following cube that was very close to zero. So even under a very bad supposition, we got a situation that point to a quantum order effect. We also did analysis of correlation that contradict our supposition of independence. That correlation analysis, I'd like to thank you for the referees that gave a good suggestion in this direction. So we conclude that the situation that best give us a situation of quantum order effects is a situation with higher correlation, which violate our supposition of independence. But according to the authors of this paper, probably there is a causality between the two events, because they know that the subjects was able to establish, they were able to establish a strategy in the situation of silence. And once they have established a strategy under the situation of silence, they had a good performance on their noise. And the reverse was not true. So if in the first time the subject was subject to noise, it was very hard to have a good performance under the situation of the silence, even though, as you saw in the numbers, there was improvement. So this one of the works. the other work at the authors Casares and Barnes, they investigate the index of pain sensitive and physiological reactive, in this case, blood pressure and heartbeat. So the stressful situation, that stressor here, was a mental arithmetic calculation. So they put first people to make a mental arithmetic calculation, and after that, the subject was in a situation of pain, and they want to know if in what order the people feel more pain. I'll jump in because it's my time is short. So again, we got this result. So MA is mental arithmetic calculation, and CP is the situation of pain. Again, we got a good result in favor of quantum or the effect. So I conclude say that the first motivation like that to bring this work here is not because this work is conclusive, but to invite the community to investigate more physiological data. We knew that our supposition of independence was not good. But even though we got a result that from a side pointed to quantum order effect. Just yesterday, we received the data set from one of the authors of this paper. So it is our intention now with the data make a much better investigation. And it's our hope to, before the send the final version of this paper to print, we have this new evaluation. But I'd like to remember that even that we find that we don't have quantum or the effect here, we know that this system is first of all contextual. Maybe not quantum contextual, but it's contextual. And we have other work like from my friend Acacio that show that there is other situations that can explain this contextuality, for example, using negative probability. So I'll pass the word to Bob to continue.
Thank you very much.
No,
you got 8 minutes in total.